tell decision makers about the decision-making process generally is, imagine that you had never had any senses or any context about your world. What decisions would you make and how? Where would anything come from? The reason that you're able to frame decisions in the first place is that you've enjoyed the benefit of human experience. And your senses have taken in information, data from the world, and stored it in your cranial web stuff. That's still data, and you're still processing it. You've been doing analytics. And what happens when you allow your senses to look around is you begin to see all the different areas that you might be interested in. You begin to get inspired. You begin to get context. You begin to know how to actually ask the right questions. And so you have this broadening of your horizons through analytics. That's what we call it when we do it with electronic data. But I don't actually like to make a huge distinction between what you do naturally with your senses and what you do with the electronic data. Just think of the electronic version, the experts in it, as being much, much faster at looking around than you might be with your natural senses. So you do this broadening. And then, well, you've looked around at all these things, what's actually important? What's worth pursuing? You're overstimulated. Now you need to take something that is the decision maker's skill, that core piece of judgment, and look at all this with your experience, with your business skills, with your good sense and decision-making training, and now you whittle it down to what is a priority, to what is most important. And then you get your most important questions, and these may involve something to do with automation or repeating some decision-making a lot, or they may involve a few very important decisions or a few very important questions. That would be statistics. And so this expanding of your horizons, that's where analytics comes in. And what happens in many companies is you skip analytics because you have this push that you need statistics. And so you end up getting really, really good answers to the wrong questions because you haven't had this process where you've broadened your horizons and gotten the right questions asked. And so if you think about machine learning and statistics as narrow pursuits, in a very, very narrow and deep pursuits, the shape of a rabbit hole, incidentally, then how do you know where what's worth digging? How do you know which rabbit hole is worth going down? You won't if you haven't taken a broad and shallow sweep. And that's what analytics does for you. And analytics is as powerful and difficult and rewarding and challenging as the other two. And I tell people, look at this broad and shallow sweep and turn it sideways. It is as narrow and deep in its own way as the other two. But you have to see it from the perspective of what it is and what it's for, to approach it properly, to manage it properly, and to get the most value out of it.